Assalamu alaikum. Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to solve heat transfer and fluid flow problem using ANSYS Fluent. The mode of heat transfer in this case is convective and radiative. The problem is taken from the heat transfer book. This is the problem with this figure. We need to find temperature values and heat transfer. These are the theoretical results found in the solution manual of the book. Let's start the ANSYS workbench. To the left side of the workbench window, you can find different analysis systems as well as component systems available in the ANSYS. Now, click and drag out the fluid analysis system to the main project scheme area. Also, drag out the geometry component to the left of the fluid and ICEM CFD component in the middle of the two. The first step is geometry modeling. Right click and click on New Space Plane Geometry. Because the shape is symmetrical, so we will make half of the geometry to use the symmetry option in the fluent, and also to have a lower number of mesh elements that need to be solved. So go to the new sketching plane, select XY plane and make it a plane view. Select the rectangle command and click at the origin and type 10 cm, press tab button and type 20 cm and hit enter. Now switch to 3D mode, press the H key for home view, select the surface and pull this surface out and type 12 meter and hit enter. Hit the select button and come to the groups tab portion. Select this surface and click create NS and name it inlet. Similarly, select this side surface and name it symmetry. Select the other three side surfaces. And name them wall. Now rotate the geometry with the middle mouse button and select the last remaining surface and name it outlet. This is it in the geometry modeling. Close this space clip window. Now transfer this geometry to the ICEM CFD component. Right click and edit model. Everything in ICEM meshing will be done in blocking tab. So go to the blocking tab. The first step is to create block. Go to create block. Type fluid in the part area. Select geometry. Click and drag to select all the entities and press middle mouse button to done it. The second step is to associate block edges with the geometry edges. In Edit Associations, select Associate Edge to Curve. Click and drag the pointer to select all the blocking edges and press middle mouse button to help it. Click and drag the pointer second time to select geometry's edges and press middle mouse button to. The third step is to create O grid. Go to split block and select O grid block. Now go to the select edges option and select these two edges on the symmetry face. Press middle mouse button to done it and hit the apply button to generate O grid topology. Now to reduce the length of this highlighted edge, go to edit block and select modify O grid. Pick this select edges option and select this diagonal edge. Type the offset value of 0.5 and hit apply to rescale the O grid. The last step is to provide the number of nodes to each edge. Go to pre-mesh parameter and select edge parameter. Scroll down and check the copy parameter box back at the top. Pick the select edges option and select this largest 12 meter edge and assign 1000 nodes for this edge. Pick the select edges option again and select this 20 centimeter side edge and assign 20 nodes for this edge. Again, pick the select edges option and select this 10 centimeter top edge and assign 10 nodes for this edge. Now for the last time, pick the select edges option and select this diagonal edge and assign 8 nodes. Also on the side 1 of this edge, provide a first cell height or spacing of 0.001 and a growth rate of the cell is 1.2. Now expand this blocking portion in the tree and check the pre-mesh box and hit yes. Select this solid simple display under the display options. Here you can see the whole mesh created and on the inlet face you can see the first small cell and cell growth. In the output mesh tab, select solver and since Fluent is already selected, hit apply. This is it in ICMCFD. So close this application. Grab the model cell under ICMCFD and transfer it to the setup cell in the Fluent. Right click in the model cell and update. Here you can see the progress. Now right click and edit the Fluent setup. Check the double precision option. I am selecting the 2 cores out of my 6 core CPU. I also have one dedicated GPU in my system. After that, click start. It brings up the Fluent window. The first thing is to change the units from Kelvin to Celsius for temperature. Now moves to the physics tab. Turn on the energy model to solve the heat transfer option of the problem, and to solve the fluid flow portion of the problem, go to viscous model. Select K epsilon realizable with enhanced wall treatment. Also check the thermal effects and viscous heating option and hit OK. The next step is to define the material. Click on materials. The material is already here, as the material have different properties at a different temperature. So at around 50 degrees Celsius, the density is 1.092, CP value is 1007, thermal conductivity is 0.02735. And the dynamic viscosity is 1.65 E - 5. Click change, create and close. Here you can see the changed properties. The next step is to apply the material to the domain. Click cell zone, select fluid. The material type is already fluid. Click edit. The air material is already applied. Click OK. The next step is to apply the boundary conditions. Click boundaries. Select the inlet boundary. Here we have different types of boundaries, and the boundary type is already velocity inlet. Click edit. Here provide a velocity magnitude of 4 meter per second and move to the thermal tab. Provide a temperature value of 60 and click OK. Similarly, select the outlet boundary, and the boundary type is already pressure outlet. Click edit. Here, no need to change anything and click OK. Select the symmetry boundary, and the boundary type is already symmetry. Select the walls boundary, and the boundary type is already a wall. Click edit. Here in the momentum tab, keep everything as it is and go to the thermal tab. We have a convection boundary condition as well as a radiation boundary condition. So move to the next mixed type boundary and provide a heat transfer coefficient value of 10, free shattering temperature 10, emissivity 0.3, external radiation temperature is 10, and click OK. Now the boundaries are fully defined. Move to the solution tab. Select the solution method. Change the discretization scheme to second order. In the initialization method, hybrid is already selected. Click initialize. In calculation, click run calculation. Provide 500 number of iterations. Here we can also see a mesh in the fluent. Now click calculate. Now the calculations are completed and after 106 iterations, the solution is converged with the convergence criteria of 1E minus 6 for the energy equation and 1E minus 3 for all other parameters. Hit OK. Close the application. Right click the result cell and edit. Rotate the model to adjust its view. Click the insert contour, keep the same name and click OK. Select outlet in the location. Select the temperature in the variable list and hit apply. To change the legend view, double click default legend view 1. In details, go to the Appearance tab and change the precision type to Fixed. Now, change the location to Walls to view the temperature contour on the walls. Similarly, we can see the temperature contour on the symmetry plane. Click the Insert Streamlines, keep the same name and click OK. Select the inlet boundary for the start location and change the number of points to 100. To change the appearance of the streamlines, go to the symbol tab and change the line width value to 5. You can even change the stream type to the tube and provide a tube width of 1. Oh, change the value to 0.2. Add the number of points to 50. So you can adjust these settings according to your requirement. Now come to the expression tab and create a new expression. Right click and click new and name it temp. In the definition area, right click, go to functions, CFD post and select area average. Within parentheses, right click and select temperature variable and after add symbol, provide the outlet boundary as a location. Here we have a temperature value in Kelvin and -273.15 Kelvin. In the expression to change the temperature value to Celsius. One thing keeps in mind that the units here are case sensitive and you should provide capital K here. Now hit apply. The resulting temperature value of 44.7067 is in degree Celsius. Now change the location from outlet to walls to see the surface temperature, which is 32.7 degrees Celsius. Add another expression to measure the heat transfer or heat loss. Right click and click new and name it Q. In the definition area, right click, go to functions, CFD post and select area integral. Within parentheses, right click and select wall heat flux variable. Add after add symbol, provide the wall's boundary as a location. Hit apply. Here, because of the symmetry, we have a half surface area, so the heat transfer. That's why we need to multiply this expression by 2. Here, we have a heat transfer value of 2560.67 watt. This is it in the CFD post. Now close it and save your project. Here is the resulting comparison graph showing the difference between theoretical and CFD results. You can see the difference in temperature values at the duct exit and the duct walls respectively, corresponding to the left temperature axis, and the heat transfer value difference in this third column corresponding to the right heat transfer axis. Here in this table, the percentage difference in the temperature and heat transfer values is shown, and the difference is insignificant and we have acceptable results. This is it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching. If you like this effort, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel.